Coming up, we will take a look at Windows Defender Advanced Threat Protection for Windows 10, including how it works at scale to process behavioral events that flag attacks using security machine learning and analytics, and its new capabilities with the Creators Update for detecting, investigating, and containing breaches, including in-memory attacks and kernel exploits. With the anniversary update, we have added a new service for EDR, Endpoint Detection and Response, to find threats that made it pass all other defenses. It runs side by side with Windows Defender Antivirus or other third-party AV solutions. Windows Defender ATP adds a post-breach layer to complete the Windows security stack. It provides exposure of otherwise undetected threats, tools to investigate and understand the scope of breach, and the ability to contain and respond to threats to prevent or limit damage. It's built into Windows 10, so no additional agent or on-prem infrastructure is required. Insights from your onboarded machines are surfaced in the cloud-based Windows Defender Advanced Security Center for monitoring, investigating your endpoints, and take actions. Here I have a production environment, as you can see here on our dashboard. This gives you an aggregate view of the latest alerts, their severity, when they were observed. The machines most at risk with the number of alerts related to each machine. Users at risk, which comprises insights into their activities, actions, and relationships to machine. You will see active malware detections if you have Windows Defender Antivirus as your primary AV solution. And information on onboarded machines, those that are misconfigured or inactive, as well as service health. Before I drill further into investigation, let me explain what's happening behind the scenes to present this console. Windows Defender ATP uses the following combination of technology built into Windows 10 and Microsoft's cloud services. Focusing on activity at the endpoints, we collect behavioral signals from your onboarded endpoints. That allows us to not only provide alerts for known adversaries, but also unknown, never seen before attacks, even zero-day exploits, or attacks that reside in memory and never touch the disk. This data will get sent to your own dedicated Windows Defender ATP tenant, separated from other customers. From the cloud, we are leveraging big data, machine learning, analytics, and Microsoft unique optics. We will look into all the signals we get from our over 200 consumer and commercial services. Think about our Azure services, such as Azure AD or Office, Office 365, Outlook, Hotmail, Bing. This also includes intel collected by our security hunters and researchers, plus industry partners. All of this intelligence feeds into your personalized view of your environment. It provides tools to investigate the scope of breach or suspicious behaviors and to take action to block files or quarantine affected endpoints. If you're using a SIEM solution, you can feed your alerts into it and manage your incidents from there. Now let's move to my demo environment to see how you can investigate suspicious events, identify the attack motivation, understand the potential scope of a breach, and take action. Let's have a look at the machine with a high severity alert. Here I can investigate it further. This includes an overview of security relevant details, such as logged on users and how they connected to this machine, and a list of all alerts for this machine. We have also built this rich timeline where you can see all events observed from this machine. And we are showing you this for all your data for up to 6 months. You can interactively hunt, search, and explore of historical data across your endpoints. Beyond just detection, for every event, we show you the entire process tree. Let's drill into a few of these alerts. The detailed view, including the entire process tree, shows you that a process has injected code into another process. Here, winword.exe injected to process scvhost.exe. The ability to do in-memory detection is new with the Creators Update. I will also review the red alert that we saw earlier. I can see that it's a kernel exploit. In this case, we show you how a system token got applied to a process that was originally running in user mode. And because Windows Defender ATP can integrate with Microsoft Office, it also gets additional user details displayed right in the console. Beyond users, other things that I can do is hunt for evidence of attacks, such as file names or hashes, IP addresses or URLs, behaviors, machines, or users. I can search my organization's cloud inventory across all machines and go back up to 6 months in time, even if machines are offline, have been reimaged, or no longer exist. Here I'm going to search for a file. This page shows me all the details of a file. I can also see if it is associated with a specific alert, behavior, or submit the file for detonation to help determine if the file exhibits malicious activities. This gives me a full report back of what the file is actually doing. For instance, here I can see it tries to modify proxy configuration, it's capable to do installation and gain persistence. Once you have determined that the file is suspicious, you can perform action. I can also take action at a machine level, but I will save this for our upcoming Microsoft Mechanic Show on Windows Defender Advanced Threat Protection, where we will also cover integration with Office 365 ATP. So that was a quick tour of Windows Defender ATP. As the threat landscape changes, this is an area of continuous innovation. We will continue to invest in new capabilities and expand support to other platforms, starting with Windows Server 2012 R2 and 2016. You can learn more and sign up for a trial today by following the link below. Thanks for watching.